What can we expect out of the stock market in the weeks and months ahead? Stick around to get a few of my thoughts on this topic. I've been either in or affiliated with the financial services market for 38 years, and I would have to say there are few times within that long expanse of years that I can remember as much volatility in the stock market as we've seen in recent weeks. Now, where is the market going from here? Well, as I record this, it's the 29th of March 2020. As I said, we've just gone through a very, very volatile period where the market was just in free fall, went from a sustained rally and bull market that lasted just over 11 years to a correction and then a bear market within a very short time period. And this is not what we need right now, dealing with one national crisis and then to see a healthy economy and a strong stock market and then have the bottom fall out on it. So, what could happen in the weeks and months ahead with the stock market? And how should you be looking at it? Here's the way I see it. There are often multiple schools of thought on the market on any particular day about what stocks may outperform, what stocks to avoid, what the market might do. You know, we in the U.S. we can look at the overnight activity in other markets like the Asian markets. We can look at the future markets and see if we get a good feeling about what the market may do on a particular day. A lot of people look at technical indicators first thing in the morning and try to get some idea of the direction individual stocks might go in. But right now, it really comes down to two major schools of thought. It's almost like there's a tug of war between two schools of thought right now. And that is what we've seen pull the market down in recent weeks, and that's why we've seen the market rally back in more recent days and then slide off again. What it really comes down to right now is both based on human psychology and the perception of different people about the future. And this is two things that normally drive the market anyways on any given day. But right now, it's more evenly divided into two very definite schools of thought. So the one school of thought goes like this. The government has just provided an enormous help package. You could call it stimulus, but it is really designed to help people. So this giant help package that I believe they called the care package to help both individuals, people that are now finding themselves out of work, small businesses that have been hard hit, service businesses and entertainment businesses that have been especially hard hit, anything from bars to restaurants to entertainment complexes like Disney to other venues that host entertainment, to barbershops and beauty salons and dentist offices. All these different sectors of our economy have been hard hit. So there's one group of people right now who are feeling good about this stimulus package and the fact that the Federal Reserve has taken some action recently. And this group of people also are hopeful that we are going to turn the corner on this pandemic sometime in the weeks ahead. So, in other words, you have a school of thought that says that there's a group of investors that are optimistic that the curve will be flattened sometime in the near future so that our healthcare system can stay on top of new cases. And because of that, we will get through this, and then our economy will be in a position to go back to being great guns like it was before this. Because keep in mind, in January and February, we only had 3.5% unemployment. The economy overall was doing quite good by all measures. And so you have one school of thought of people who feel optimistic that we'll be able to turn the corner in the weeks ahead without things going on too much longer, and that when the market comes back, it's going to roar back. It's going to rally once again, and the economy will not lose too much of its footing, but get right back to being in good shape. There's an opposing school of thought, and I don't want to call these people the optimist and the pessimist, and at this point I can't even call them the realist and the, you know, and the wishful thinkers, because it's too soon to say. But the other school of thought is a little more pessimistic, and they're looking at the exponential growth in diagnosed cases of this disease, the growing death toll, not only around the world, but in the United States, places like New York, in New York City in particular, you know, parts of Washington State, California, New Jersey, that have been especially hard hit. And so the other school of thought is that because the economy has been so hard hit, we've seen record low unemployment, and then within the past week or so, we've seen more than 3 million new unemployment applications, which will most likely just continue to go up. And we've heard mixed signals and mixed opinions from people who are epidemiologists, infectious disease doctors, virologists, and other professionals who themselves are either feeling a little more optimistic or pessimistic about what to anticipate in the weeks ahead. And because of the experts who think this is going to drag on into the summer months, that would be very hard on the U.S. economy. This whole thing, of course, has been hard on the world economy. But there are a lot of people, including a lot of institutional investors and hedge fund managers and other people, who are a little more pessimistic and believe that if this does drag on, you know, how much more can the president and the Congress do? You know, we just spent $2.2 trillion, a good portion of GDP. How much more can we do? And then also, how much longer can the country go without people acting as consumers at the rate that they were before, as well as all the people that are out of work? You have all these businesses that have been shuttered, and so this other group who is more likely been involved in selling off stocks are more pessimistic about the future of the market. And of course, those people are also maybe now sitting on the sidelines and not willing to jump back in because they just believe it's too early to do so. Now, what will determine the outcome of the market because of this is what will happen in, I would say, the next 2 or 3 or 4 weeks as we get into mid-April. You know, will hospital admissions peak out? Will the curve be flattened enough that not everyone is sick at the same time and the healthcare system is not overwhelmed? You know, will there be parts of the country that will be beyond the peak and where they can start returning to work? Of course, we don't want necessarily to bring people together in groups too soon. There's been some evidence that I've heard from different infectious disease doctors around the world, including an interview I saw with South Korea's top infectious disease doctor the other day, who said that we're finding that some people that we believe we've had in the hospital and cured have been sickened again, once again, with the coronavirus after they've checked out and they've been tested and assumed to be healthy. So we really have to be certain that we're not putting infected people back out on the streets and that there's not a false sense that people are fully healed when they're not, because then you just perpetuate this and it goes on and on. So it really depends on what you feel at this moment. It will really be revealing in the weeks ahead as to whether or not officials and healthcare professionals are able to get a handle on things and keep up with things, and then we'll know better. But if things don't improve in the weeks ahead, then the economy, of course, is in danger. Obviously, we haven't even wanted to use the R word, even though technically that's where we're at now. But I have heard people use the D word, and you know, that's not good. We don't want to get there. We've seen the central banks in other countries too try to take action to use whatever tools they have available. But we certainly don't want to get into a worldwide depression, and certainly not the United States. So let's be hopeful that we can turn things around. As long as enough people are sheltering in place, taking this very seriously, not congregating with other people, we should be able to slow down the community spread I would say to a manageable level, but it won't be to a manageable level. It will be to a bearable level, I suppose. So stick around. Please keep watching this channel. I will talk about both personal finance as well as some additional videos on COVID-19 and maybe some tips about living in these unusual and surreal times. If you like this video, please hit the like button. I'd appreciate that. But like I said, please subscribe, come back often. The whole idea is to produce content that will be beneficial to you, that you can use. And like I said, I've spent many years in financial services, so this is a subject area that I'm very familiar with. Thanks for watching. Stay healthy and take care.